Hi, my name is Annelise, and this is my How to Read Literature Like a Professor project. I was given chapter 14, which is the Christ Figures section, and that's why the picture of Jesus to the left. So, the first question we have to ask is, what does it mean to be a Christ figure? So, it's pretty self-explanatory. A Christ figure is a prophetic character that parallels Jesus or other spiritual leaders. A Christ figure usually exhibits at least one of the following. So if it has one, it is an example of it. But if it has more, it also can be. It does not have to have all of these, is the main point. We have self-sacrifice, being 33 years old, unmarried, wounded or marked in the hands, feet, or side, good with children, very forgiving, spent time in the wilderness, or in agony. And something to note that I think is really important that people don't always realize is that women can also be considered Christ figures. And in fact, a lot of times they are. People automatically think of a man when they think of a Christ figure because Jesus is a man. But something to note is that, yes, women can also be Christ figures. And you can find a lot of examples of that in movies and books. So another question to ask is, why do writers include Christ figures? So obviously there's a point to it. They're trying to make a point by using them. It could be to help deepen our sense of the character's sacrifice if we view it as similar to the greatest sacrifice of our knowledge, which is Jesus. It could also be that it has to do with redemption or hope as a main theme of the work. So when you think of Jesus, obviously you think of redemption and hope because that's what he stands for. So that could help you kind of understand the piece better and understand the character who's trying to do the same thing. It also might be sort of ironic, as if to make the character look smaller rather than greater. So a little bit of irony can be played in as well. So the first example of a Christ figure that I chose is Harry Potter. He's one of the strongest and most well-known examples of a Christ figure. This is because he's considered the chosen one, like Jesus. And just like Jesus, Harry is targeted even before his birth, but survives with protection. And they were both destined to be the saviors of the world. Throughout schooling, just like Jesus, Harry is hated by his classmates who don't believe that he is the chosen one. And perhaps the most prominent example of Harry being a Christ figure is when he sacrifices himself to save his friends and those battling at Voldemort, just as Jesus sacrificed himself for humanity. And that's something that I think most of these stem from, the idea of sacrifice. That's something that was a main idea about Jesus. He sacrificed himself for all of us. So, obviously, Harry Potter sacrificing himself is a really big example of how he's a Christ figure. And I'd say it's the main one when it comes to Harry Potter. And the next example that I chose is Superman, specifically in Man of Steel. To begin with, he is 33 years old, which is the same age as Jesus. And just like Jesus, his birth is miraculous. Superman's parents don't want him to become Superman, but just as Jesus is, he's a savior, so he does it anyways. And at age 33, which is the same age that Jesus did this, he sacrifices himself to save the people of the world. So obviously, again, sacrificing is a big deal when it comes to Christ figures. But in this case, a big deal also was the fact that he was 33, and I think that was very intentional. My last choice for an example is Simba from The Lion King, and that might be kind of shocking for someone to hear. But if you look deeply into the story, you can kind of see it pretty well. He represents Jesus in many ways, and he's one of the most prominent examples, actually, of Christ figures included in Disney films. So his birth is probably the thing that pops out the most, at least to me, because it's very similar to the birth of Jesus, as they're both seen as the newborn kings and bowed down to and surrounded by, in Simba's case, animals, but in Jesus' case, humans. And it's with hundreds witnessing it. And it's kind of like crowning the new king. And it's very much similar if you really watch it. And I'll show a clip in the next slide because that's the clip I chose, which is Simba's birth. And if you pay attention, you can definitely see the similarities. And though he doesn't literally die, everyone thinks he dies. All the animals think he dies. So it's kind of similar to how Jesus died. And then there's a resurrection that occurs when he returns to the Pride Rock to save his animals from Scar, which makes him a savior just like Jesus. And, of course, my video, which is Simba's birth. I will say I like the music, and that's one of the reasons I chose it, but it also symbolizes Jesus's birth really well. It might be quicker if I just do it this way. So obviously that was a pretty good example. If you look closely, you can see everyone bowing down to him and praising him just like Jesus. So yeah, that's all I have for my presentation, and I hope you enjoyed it.